So, this is me trying to do some video capture using Snagit. What I have right here is my OGRE sample browser. I just compiled this. So I double tapped on it. My graphics settings are already set up. And here it comes. It's loading all of its samples. And I want to prove to the world that it's not just a still image. So I want to prove to the world that what I've got here is in fact a real rendering engine that's capable of doing various things. Particle effects, shader system shadows, skybox, smoke. Wait a second, didn't I see an environment cube? I'm looking for an environment cube. Cube mapping. Here it is. So environment cube has been replaced with cube mapping. What's notable here is, of course, that the reflection of the little fishy is visible in a distorted way inside our mascot OGRE head. That's our mascot OGRE head. So the thing is that I can prove to you that this is no usual environment cube, also known as cube mapping. This is called an in-scene reflection, also known as a real-time reflection. Basically, at least four different camera positions are rendering the fish, each of them to a different face of a six-sided cube. The top doesn't need to be rendered, I suppose, but you notice something, even the moving sky seems to be visible on our OGRE head. So it seems as though even though the sky is being rendered, which means that technically only one of the six cube faces corresponding to the floor down here doesn't need to be rendered in real time. So the thing is, the ability of OGRE 1.8.1 to do this depends on its ability to do a render to texture to one specific square belonging to a cube, belonging to the six faces of a cube, and to do multiple renders to multiple squares belonging to multiple faces of that cube. So anyway, that's all I wanted to show people. That's it for me. Wait.